Ashley, thanks for joining us today and to talk about this important fundraiser. Since 2013, almost 450 people from Niagara have turned to ARID Recovery Homes, three locations for post-addiction recovery. ARID's 22nd annual walkathon is taking place all this month. Sandy Day is the walkathon chair. Sandy, a few changes, obviously, to this year's fundraiser.
Yeah, for sure. It's our first virtual fundraiser. Last year we got canceled, so we're trying something new on.
When you look at the financial challenge of not being able to run last year's fundraiser, how did that affect the three homes?
Oh, wow. Significantly, because our walkathon typically is between 10,000 and 15,000. So that would, you know, if you use that for day-to-day operations, it would stretch out for quite a bit.
Between the three homes, I know the last time we talked a couple of years ago at one of the walks, you right. were doing some upgrades to the kitchens. Mm-hmm. Is that work, I'm assuming, is all done. What are the plans for the future for the money that's raised this year and beyond?
Well, that year, we did put all those funds towards a new kitchen here in the women's home, and that got complete. The second year, it would have gone to some washroom renovations and stuff like that. This year, it's going to go for the day-to-day operations.
Sandy, during the pandemic, have you found that there was a higher volume of calls, people reaching out to ARID for connections to recovery organizations?
Yeah, well, our phone's been ringing like crazy, even if we're not a fit for that person or them for us. Yeah, they're isolated. They're reaching out. They've been cut off from all their supports.
I've been to your walk before with the Source. Usually it's a 2.5K or a 10K walk. How is it working this year with the online format?
Well, people can walk on their own time. Usually we have one day set where we all walk together. So we opened it up for the whole month of May, depending on the weather. You go out, do the walk on your own, do 5K, 10K. We threw in the 2.5K just for folks who maybe have a walker or wheelchair or some sort of ability that slows them down. And send your pledges online. We have an online platform that's specific for walkathon. And we're doing it that way, hoping people will take pictures, videos, tag us on Facebook, show us their walk.
So it's going to take place all through the month of May. Do you expect that your fundraising goal will be reached quite easily this year, or will it be more challenging?
I'm not sure really, to be honest, Mike. Like, I know it'll be different. It's our first time, so I don't have anything to go off of. I'm hoping we reach our goal. I'm hoping we get past it. I know there's a lot of folks that are, you know, struggling financially as well, you know, and some folks who are still working and have money available to them and are looking for things to do and looking for different ways to connect and stay engaged with their community. So it's hit and miss, really.
You have locations in Welland, Fort Erie, and Thorold. Are all the beds filled at this point in time?
Well, at the women's house, they're full because we have single rooms, but the guys' houses got cut to half capacity because some of the guys are in a shared room.
Right.
So we can't do that during COVID. So that's why this year the funds will be for day-to-day operations versus, you know, a big capital project or something like that.
That would be a huge problem, that lower capacity during the pandemic. What other challenges has COVID-19 brought you?
Well, mostly that, just the half capacity for the guys, because two of our houses are for men, only the ones for women. The other thing is the expenses of PPE and all the other safety measures, low intakes, because people aren't even sure if we're open. If the stage of recovery that they're in before us is not available, they're not getting to us either. So if a treatment center isn't open or they're at low capacity, then they're not coming to us on intake as quickly as they would have before.
Sandy, let's hope that this fundraiser makes a big difference for you financially. How can we find out more about it?
You can go to our main website, aridhomes.ca, and then on the front page, you'll see donate to our walkathon, participate in the walkathon, create a team. Just click on that and it will take you to the walkathon platform. That's the easiest way.